a very unusual hat. I wonder what's under a hat such as that. It could be a creature they call the gazat, who bounces things on his head, cause it's flat. Or a striped-wearing pipester from upper mount back, or some sort of kind of a hat-wearing cat! I can see you've got quite a mind for your age. Why, one thing, and you frighten me right on the stage. Now I'm here. There's no telling what may ensue. A cat such as me, and a thinker like you. Oh, the things you can think, oh, the things you can think, if you're willing to try. Think invisible ink, or gink with a stink, or stare to the sky. If you open your mind, oh, the things you can find, lining up to get loose. Oh, the things you can think, when you think about Suess. Oh, the things you can think, any thinker who thinks can come up with a few. Oh, the things you can think, make a trip on a ship, do the liver of pip, or do solid salute. Think a beautiful schlock with a cherry on top. You don't need an excuse.
Now think of an elephant mumbling Horton!
Yes, Horton!
Horton, here's a who!
On the 15th of May, in the jungle of Newell, in the heat of the day, in the cool of the pool, he was splashing, enjoying the jungle's great joys, when Horton the elephant,
Horton the elephant,
Horton the elephant, heard a small voice,
help! Huh? Help!
So Horton stopped splashing, he looked towards the cell.
That's funny.
Thought Horton,
there's no one around. And he heard it again,
a very faint yelp,
as if some tiny person were calling for help. But who are you and where?
He looked and he looked, he could see nothing there.
But a small speck of dust went past through the air. I say, you're confusing. I've never tell of a small speck of dust as empty out. So you know what I think? I think there must be someone on top of that small speck of dust. Poor little person that's shaking with fear, had a blown in the pool, had just no way to steer. Alone in the universe. Just have to save him, because after all, a person's a person, no matter how small. A person's a person, no matter how small.
And I heard them quite clear. I know there's a person down there, and what's more, most likely there's two, maybe three, four.
I just don't believe Horton's out of his mind.
them, because after all, a person's a person, no matter how small. A person's a person, no matter how. let you down. No, I won't let you fall. A person's a person, no matter how small. A person's a person, no matter.
Our tiny Who family on a small rainy day.
Mom and Dad are just home from the Who PTA.
Mommy's little boy.
He was Daddy's little man.
He was never any trouble till this stinking thing began.
We must both lay down the law. Maybe so.
Oh, well, the instructions on how to write the job. It was the instructions on how to write it down. Someone's on the answers.
I don't know.
Jojo, I'm mayor of Who. I've just been elected, and upright behavior is thus forth expected.
We just had a talk with your teacher today, and they didn't have one single good thing to say.
You've invented new things which defy all description.
You gave Miss O'Dooley a nervous conniption.
Your things were so wild they disrupted your classes and made Mrs. McAlhoo drop her new classes, which is why you're suspended.
Yes, that's what they said.
Young man, what and who has got into your head?
Now Horton has found us. We're safe on a clover. But clearly our troubles are far, far from over.
We don't mean to scold you. We love you. Oh, yes, dear. But could you just try being a little bit less, dear?
Stop telling such outlandish tales.
Stop turning minnows into whales.
Now take your bath and go to bed.
And think some normal things instead.
You got me in trouble. Get out. Go away.
All right, I'll be going. But first, let me say... Oh, the things you can think!
Stop!
Oh, the things you can think!
Be quiet!
As you splash, and you splish.
I'm not listening.
As you sit there and scrub, have a think in the tub. Think of water and fish.
Fish?
Think of pipes in the floor, leading off to a shore where the water is cool. Sitting your tub's not a tub.
It's McElligot's pool.
This might be a pool like I've read of in books, connected to one of those underground brooks. An underground river that starts here and flows right under this bathtub, and then who knows, it's possible. Anything's possible. Who's hanging out close? It's possible. Anything's possible.
It's possible.
Anything's possible. This might be a river now, mightn't it be? Connecting McElligot's pool with the sea. Then maybe some fish might be swimming toward me. It's possible. Anything. anything's possible, it's possible, anything, anything.
Jojo, the tub's overflowed on the floor, the water's running right under the door.
The ceiling is peeling, you've fallen in a den. Oh, Jojo, I think you've been thinking again.
I say this with firmness and terrible sorrow, young man, we'll deal with you come tomorrow.
After thinking, dust speck and speak. Let them all laugh. Try not to mind. For I have found something that they'll never find. There are secrets on a leaf, in the water, in the air, in a planet's tiny world, invisible. Not a person seems to know. Not a person seems to care. There is no one who believes a thing I say. Well, I'm fairly certain at one time or other, great thinkers all feel this way. Magic, but they won't see it. They all call me a lunatic. Okay, call me a lunatic. If I stand on my own, so be it. 'Cause I have wings. Yes, I can fly around the moon and far beyond. I know there you'll be. One small voice in the universe, one true friend in the universe, who believes in me.
I'm alone in the universe, so alone in the universe. My own planets and stars are glowing.
Think.
Oh, I'm real, alright. I would state that in ink.
In my things, I imagine a lot of strange things and go to strange places as if I had wings. I love a good think.
Well, for me, that goes double.
Sometimes, my things are what get me in trouble.
What do you think? Do you dream?
In bright colors.
Me too. And they go to strange places like Salisalu.
When you dream, do you think you can fly to the stars?
Little friends, no one else could ever have things such as ours.
Yes, I have wings.
I have wings.
Yes, I can
fly. I can fly.
Well, the moon and far beyond the sky. You called my name and you set me free.
One small voice in the universe.
One true friend in the universe.
Believes in me.
Good night, Jojo.
Good night, Horton. See you in Sala Saloon.
Ah, wake up! The scene's over! There's more to be heard! There goes our hero! Now enters
the bird.
Love song for Horton, number 437.
There once was a girl bird named Gertrude McFuzz, and she had the smallest plain tail ever was. One droopy, droop feather, that's all that she had. And oh, that one feather made Gertrude so sad. She curled and she tried and she gave it a puff. She tried different puffs, but it wasn't enough. For no matter what, it just was what it was. A tail that simply wasn't meant to catch the eye of an elephant. No one feather tail of Miss Fortune makes.
Sorry, sight. Well, I'm gonna take you under my wing and bid you be all right. I was once a plain little bird like you, kid. One pathetic feather was all I grew. I had nothing show-offish. What's a plain bird to do? Well, there's certainly nothing show-offish on you.
Thank you, Maisie.
Then I made a plan for my self-improvement. No more crumbs, I vowed I would have the cake. Yes, I went to the doctor.
But I could take by the lake.
And he told me what sort of a pill I should take. Now I'm amazing, Maisie, as feather as feather can be now. Amazing, Maisie, it was all.
Doctor.
Jay, lake?
His office was high in a tree by the lake.
I cry, Mr. Doctor, oh please, you know. Some kind of pillow make my tail grow.
Tut tut, the doctor said. Such talk, it's too absurd. Your little tail is just right for your kind of bird.
Then Gertrude had teardrops and right at her den. The final of the doctor just had to get it.
Yeah, right already. Bring in the puberty bush.
So Gertrude is happy. Her tail's nice and long.
Kid, fasten your seatbelt, because now things go wrong.
Fire you.
clover is somewhere inside of a huge, giant patch of clover, 100 miles wide. I'll find it or bust. I must find my friends on their small speck of dust. By clover, with care. By each one, I'll call. Are you there? Are you there? Are you there? Are you there? Nope. Are you there?
It's taking all my courage to approach you, not to mention all my stamina to follow you across hills and deserts. But I feel as if I'm ready to confess to you the feelings that I've hidden with redundance and labor. Behind the facade of your odd little next door neighbor. My eyes are too small, I have very large feet. I'm not very proud of my pitiful feet. But now you've got a tail that is something to see.
102, 103.
Oh, notice me, Horton. Pull down the clover. This is your next door neighbor calling. Notice me, Horton. Horton, together we could be great. Oh, notice me, Horton. Pull down the clover. This is your next door neighbor calling. There's a new leaf. Your neighbor's turned over,
over and over, clover by clover.
I was just a no one only yesterday. You showed up and showed me something.
Heart, so notice me, Horton.
The world would be something new.
Notice me, Horton.
They notice a thing or two.
Notice me, Horton.
The way I notice you.
Oh, it's hopeless!
You said it, kid.
What? Who's it?
It's me, Maisie, up here.
Maisie? Are you on a nest?
Yeah, you want to make something of it?
No, I just never thought I'd see you on a nest.
Neither did I, Hort. Neither did I.
Say what?
Just a girl on the wing. When I met with McFuff, oh, good at night I'll sing. Tell yourself how lucky you are.
How lucky you are.
We spent 3 weeks of bliss, and the usual say, he flew off to San Juan, leaving me with this egg. Tell yourself
cranky and tired, sitting day after day. Who knew so much work was required? I'd much rather play. I need a vacation, I'm due for some rest. Hey, Horton, would would you maybe like to sit on my nest?
Why, Maisie, of all the silly things, I haven't got feathers, and I haven't got wings. And not only that, but I'm here on a search. I can't just leave my poor who's sitting in the lurch.
Oh, I won't be gone long, kid. I give you my word. I'll hurry back, because I'm that sort of bird. Oh, hurry. I promise I'll fly back real soon. I'll only be gone for, say, one afternoon.
Well, everyone needs a vacation. Go on, take it. I'll sit on your egg, and I'll try not to break it. But hurry back soon. 1 hour, maybe two. I've got to find JoJo, and I've got to save who.
Yes, and you must. Hit it, cat. Thanks a million.
This thing is amazing. Come on, 10,000, 10,000 right here. Sold to the man with the greasy black mustache and the sideburns. Oh, okay, sorry, miss. Sold instead to the circus.
Sold.
Oh, to the circus! Oh, it can't get any worse.
Could it? Could it?
Could it get any worse?
When you're down in Palm Beach with a breeze in your hand, don't have an aunt or a master of care. Tell yourself how lucky you are.
How lucky? How lucky? So sorry.
When it's day after day, after beautiful day, to be lazing away by the sea with Jose. Tell yourself how lucky you are.
You are so lucky.
Still, I'm bored and I'm cranky and tired, sitting day after day. Who knew so much work was required for nothing but play? I need something different. I crave something new. Hey, maybe you could think of something different to do.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, critters and creatures, smallest of small and the tallest of tall. Come old and young, come one and all, to the Circus McGurkus, the world's greatest show, on the face of the earth, or wherever you go.
A circus? I love a show. I think I'll go. Gracious, I've seen you before. Now let's see.
Why, Maisie, it's me, Horton. I've sat on your egg now for 51 weeks. I've sat here while people have paid to take peeks. I've sat here through lightning and hailstorms and snow.
Why do you take back your egg?
Gee, I really don't know.
Effie.
Oh, wow, it's really late. And gee, I've got an eight, and lots of places to be, but it's so great to see you. Look at you, who would ever guess? Look at you, such a big success! And it's all thanks to me! Amazing Horton, that egg city circus sensation. Amazing Horton, even I'm impressed. Amazing Horton, while I was off taking vacation, you made your fortune off of Maisie's nest.
I may be unreliable, fancy free, irresponsible, crazy me, always eager to fly, but seeing you gives me true delight. Just for once, I've done something right.
The egg is all yours.
But the what?
No, no, thank you. I'll cry.
Good luck. And when it hatches, good luck.
And goodbye.
I meant what I said, and I said what I meant. An elephant's faithful, 100%.
And small little egg of a lonely universe too. Up to me, a fool of an elephant, up in a tree. Well, this time I swear I'll do better than try. Yes, I'll protect you from harm. Yes, I'll do it or die. Now rest now, young egg, and I'll sing you.
Thank you.
where so far away lands so the stories all tell, somewhere beyond the horizon. If we can find it, then all will be well on the day we do. Troubles will be
friend Jojo too. I hope they all made Suessical.
High on a mountain or lost on the sea, sooner or later I'll find it.
I have a picture of how it will be on the day I do.
We'll be through.
About Gertrude McFuzz.
Hmm? Wait, well, that's nothing now. I mean, everyone does.
But Gertrude is something that few words could do. This is the tale of Gertrude Part 2. Horton! Horton, are you there?
Who's there?
It's me, Gertrude. Oh, Horton, are you all right? I was so worried.
How did you find us?
Well, it's a long story.
Ooh, I like stories.
I had a little trouble because I grew a little tail. Well, it wasn't really little. It was absolutely giant. And it really was attractive, but I never even noticed, so I felt a little silly even trying. Besides which, the tail was too heavy for normal flying. So I ran to the doctor.
The doctor named Jake, and she said,
"My tail has been a mistake. Dr. Jake, I've been foolish and vain.
Pluck it out, get it off. I won't do it again.
Pluck, pluck, pluck.
Ouch, it hurt a lot.
Pluck, pluck, pluck.
Ooh, a tennis bat.
Pluck, pluck, pluck.
Just a one feather tail. Then suddenly,
there's a sail.
I sailed on a junk that was practically sunk for you.
I trampled the trees full furious bees
for you.
a jog in a smoking bog, down a soggy slope through a stinking bog. My slip was gripped by a vicious dog. For you, all for you,
all for you,
all for you. There's nothing that I wouldn't, and I couldn't, and I haven't gone through. I grind my little toe, and I hope a life so for you. Then came the inner run, they staggered on one for you. There. And maybe now you'll know I care for you.
Oh, yes. Horton, one more thing.
It took me 7 weeks, but I found your cover too.
I noticed you're amazing.
Oh, it was nothing.
Hello? Who's? Guys. Hello? Is anyone there?
Hello. Hello.
Hello.
Why, relief. Hello, Mr. Mayor. Is JoJo all right?
Hi, Horton.
Oh, JoJo. Hello. Kidding now that I get here, I'm gonna let you go. Shelter and guard you because, after all, a person's a person, no matter how small.
A person's a person, no matter how.
How did you get here?
You can't run away from the sour kangaroo. Your tree and your nest. I'm making a sour citizen. Around!
Well, wait, wait, you're taking me!
Well, Horton, we're taking you back. You're gonna be going inside. For your talking to his back and sitting on an egg, you're
versus Horton the Elephant.
Horton the Elephant.
Judge Yertle and Turtle presiding, everyone.
Defend
this charge with common respect, disturbing the peace, and loitering. On an egg.
Your Honor, this club's exhibit A. There are who's here. There are who's here. Smaller than the eye can see. It's true, sir. There are who's, sir. He's a who and so is she.
Faithful 100%. You can throw me in jail, lock me up in the zoo, but I won't desert this cake and I will not abandon food. These who's, sir, win or lose, sir, whether you believe or not, it's true, sir. There are who's, sir. I'm the only friend they've got.
Do what you want with me, Your Honor, and I won't question why.
But please save who? The tiniest planet in the sky.
Based on the evidence, I have no choice but to order the defendant, Horton the Elephant, remanded to the New World.
here. Oh, please, Mr. Meyer. You got to prove now that you really are there. So ring every doorbell. Send out the word. Make every holler. Make every word.
Attention all who's. Attention all who's. We've got to be heard. There's no time to lose. So send out a shout. Make it loud.
I believe in you all. A person's a person, no matter how small. And you very small persons will not have to die if you make yourself a heart to play strong.
We are here. We are here. We are here. We are here. We are here.
Just for a moment, young JoJo is grim. The fate of all hoops is squarely on him. Then came a think, a peculiar new word, kind of a word no one ever had heard.
We are here, we are here, we are here, we are here. We are here.
Yup!
Did you hear what I hear? Did you see what I mean? They made themselves
heard,
yet they still can't be seen.
And they prove they are a person, no matter how small.
And their world was saved by the smallest of all.
How true, yes, how true, said the sour kangaroo. And from now on, you know what I'm planning to do?
What?
From now on, I'm planning to protect them with you. And the young kangaroo and her pal said, me too.
Great,
yeah!
And JoJo is honored as thinker non-stop.
Now all JoJo thinks will forever be heard,
including his newest think.
Like me, except for the wings.
And except for the voice, because that's how a bird sings.
Yeah, Gertrude, what'll I do? Slow and I'm fat. All I know is the earth. I need a lot more than that. And I just have that.
I have wings. Yes, I can fly. I will teach him sky.
Just call my name and I'll see you through.
One small voice in the universe.
One true friend in the universe.
Believes in you.
The adventure's over. The sky turned bright
pink.
And then guess what happened?
Well, what do you think?
Oh, the things you can think. Think and wonder and dream. Far and wide as you dare.
Oh, the things you can think.